Bodega Boys.
Oh my God, this is so beautiful. Oh my God, after the pandemic and just everything they went through, and your father's still in jail because he gouged out a cop's eyes in the Capitol riot, and all he was doing was supporting MAGA. I don't understand why they let these social justice warriors allow. They put him on the bench, and Clarence Thomas is a coon, but that's neither here nor there. But it's Mother's Day, and you took me to one of the biggest and nicest spots on Long Island. Oh, my God. I saw it on Desus and Mero. This is where they took Big Time Tommy. Oh, Michael Anthony. Yeah. Sometimes you do my heart so well. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you know, I try to do good. I try to tell you, stupid fucking ass. Like, I'm a good kid. You know?
You're a great kid.
It was like breaking my balls.
You're the apple of my eye. I remember, God. I got a train ran on me
That's
once.
That's right.
On Arthur Ave. And I was like, God, as long as I don't have a kid right here by one of these mouleons, I promise I will have a great kid. And you're my great kid. You're my great kid.
There you go. There you go. See? That you know, the sister never mind. Actually,
I have the Narcan. I have the Narcan. So feel free to do your thing today, okay?
All right. So listen, I got you this nice present, you know?
Oh.
I know it's like you like brunches and stuff like that, you know?
So, I got love you them brunch. So much. I love them,
that's
especially
why I took you.
Because I'm not going to be one of these sheep and fall for this pandemic. Like, I want indoor dining, okay?
That's right.
I want to eat indoors. I want someone to be inside eating on near
that's
me.
Good.
I mean, excuse me.
Yeah,
you know?
That's why we're sitting in here elbow to elbow with a bunch of fucking assholes, Mom. That's because I love you and I don't want you to die.
And I love you too. And that's why we don't have on any masks like, you know, like they do in Harlem. God forbid.
Yeah.
Oh, my
yeah,
God.
You know. I mean, you know how those they guys. Are. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
table
I
for
think
two.
Just wearing
Do you know the father?
Sticker.
I mean, that's neither here nor there, but okay. Black
they're
people.
Just, they just wear masks to be cool. But anyway, Mom, look at my phone here. I got a smartphone, right? I got it from my friend Julio, and I got this thing
God.
Called like,
Julio again.
Yeah. He's a good guy now.
Tamales? You're going to get
legit.
In trouble. You're going to get
legit,
indigestion
Mom.
In your court system. You
Mom, no, he's
out.
Legit. He has Listen. Four bodegas. He says he's doing really well with them. He doesn't do drugs anymore. He doesn't sell drugs anymore.
I saw on
Just
the news
me.
Something bad is happening in his country. I think it's Gazanbo Beans is taking over the economy or something. They're burning tires in the streets. Stay away. Stay away.
Listen, you don't got to worry about any of that, Ma. I got you covered. You don't have to worry about money ever again.
Really?
Because I got you. Yes, Ma.
What'd
I love you
me?
So much. Julio put me on to, let me see. What's this thing called? I wrote it down here. Cryptocurrency.
Oh my
it's
God,
like,
cryptocurrency. Oh,
yeah,
I saw something about that with John Stossel on 2020. It was so good. It was so good.
Like,
and they dumbed it down and they used really easy words so even someone as stupid as me could understand. So I loved it. And I forwarded it on Facebook to everyone in my Cops Lives Matter wife group. So,
yeah, you know. Perfect. So now I got you 16 dog food coins from Julio.
Oh my God, you got
amazing.
Me Dogecoin? Yeah. Oh, it's going to the moon. Elon Musk is good. He was just on SNL.
Wait.
This is going to be fantastic. Dogecoin
no.
is like it's super
it's
popular. It's Doge. It's named after Doja Cat. I read all about this.
No.
It's super
nah,
good.
This is different.
It's based on pop and it's what? Excuse me?
No, this is that. Nah, this is not that. It's like
I know,
are you talking
I know
about like
about
the Elon Musk thing?
I slept with Crips. I know what's going on. What are you talking about?
This is dog food coin, man. This is a different thing. All right? It's not. It's like you fucking like. Well, how dumb are you? Are you fucking dumb? Elon Musk mustard guy is the one that does the Doge. This is dog food coin. This is going beyond. This is going past the moon.
Oh, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and Mike, please pray for my soul. Hey, for
my
soul.
Like,
you bought?
What are you gonna do
heroin?
With it?
You bought heroin coins, Michael? Michael,
I mean,
did you buy heroin coins?
No.
What do you think a
dog food
coin is? What do you think dog food? Why would you buy dog food coins? They're not
you
worth
don't even,
anything.
Yes, they are. You just gotta tie it off and put it in your veins. That's
the
how you store it.
The coin for dog food coins closed down. It was the old McDonald's by the West Side Highway. Everyone knows that. Oh, you. Again, you disappoint me. Again.
You're a fucking bitch. I tried to do something nice for you on Mother's Day, and this is how you repay me, you fucking bitch. I hate your guts. Go fuck yourself. You know what? Pay for this fuck. I didn't even pay for this brunch. Pay for this brunch with dog food coin. You fucking cunt. Get out of my face. I can't stand you. I gotta try to do something nice. God damn it. I'm gonna call dad and have him arrest you. Bitch. I'm gonna call ACS, even though I'm 34.
Oh, he talks so badly about me, but it's just nice to spend time with my sweet gabagool. It's episode 241 of the Bodega Boys podcast. Call your mama. Or your baby's mama, you know, if you're Nubian.
What? Happy Mother's Day, guys.
You're listening to The Audio Art, the most dangerous podcast in the universe. Do the drop.
You know the vibe. Episode 241, aka the stop on the 2 train where they bang the flashlight against the pole to let you know it's the last stop on the train, and they're going to do a superficial whisk with a weird wet mop as if they're cleaning the train, and they're not. They're not.
That's my favorite thing. That's my favorite thing about the end of the train when they get on the train and they just like mop the floor with a bucket of mud. And they're like, yo, we clean the clay. It's clean. It's clean now. We got it.
That was surface clean. Why is it still sticky? 233rd. If you fell asleep and then you missed getting off at 233rd, you could, if you got off at the next stop, you could walk over, but it was like 4 blocks. But if you took the train all the way to the last stop and it came right back, it made sense. But it never worked like that. You always ended up sitting an extra half hour. You was like, damn, I should have just walked. But every New Yorker has a story like that. You know the fucking vibes.
Yeah, hell yeah,
dog. Fucking vibes. Can we back here?
Over here, baby.
The world's most dangerous podcast that survived the pandemic. It is what? Bodega Boys. That's right. Get it right or get it right at you.
The As always,
sponsored by Cash App, Ozempic, Narcan, K2, and Sarah J.
You know Sarah the fucking J. vibes. Shout out to Sarah J, yo. You know what I'm saying?
The F-150 of porn.
You know what I'm saying? The right. word. Yo, listen, talk about it. You know what I'm saying?
Talk
the motherfucking Ford Explorer of Pino, B. You know what I'm saying? Fleet vehicle. Get it? You know what I mean? Built for it tough. Well, you got to pull mad weight.
Well, you got to pull a tree out the ground.
Vroom, vroom.
You know what I'm saying?
Vroom, vroom. Vroom.
Make way. Make way. It's Sarah J.
Go, man. Yo, Sarah J got to be like a character in Bob the Builder or some shit.
Nothing but respect to legends.
Legend.
When she retires, you're going to know what she did. LeBron numbers. And you're like, wow.
Wolf. Wow.
Yo. Good work.
All right. She had mad different hairstyles, all of that. Y'all niggas, y'all don't remember.
She wasn't Chauncey Billups on the Knicks, okay? She put in that work.
Facts. Y'all wasn't there for the onion booty days.
You're right. Respect that. Right now, the NSA agent is like, yeah, they're coming in Susio off the top.
Yeah,
like,
super Susio off the top, bro.
I mean, no. That's what you come here for. Susio, sociology.
For the whole week.
Because if that, I saw a tweet, and someone was like, we're just caricatures of New York City culture. And I was like, I don't think that's possible. Aren't we just New Yorkers?
Yeah, like, you fucking idiot. Yo, that's my favorite thing to see, but not, and I know exactly what you're talking about, because I saw the same thing, and I almost did a Mero, and I was like, nope. You're different now. You know what I'm saying? You're not doing this. I was just like, yo, bro, look, the fact of the matter is we are New Yorkers. We act like New Yorkers. We are born and bred New Yorkers. That's what it is. Like, niggas, we grown men. We spend our entire lives in the Bronx.
I did not even think that deeply about it. I was like, what? This shit don't make no sense, nigga. Like, yeah, no. If anything, if you are from New York and you know about born and bred New Yorkers, they become characters of New York. Okay, who's the guys in the corner still drinking 40s? New Yorkers, right? All right,
hello,
New Yorkers. It's like Bridget Therabithia when they drank the potion to give them to live forever and it froze them at whatever age. Every Bronx New Yorker was like, "Yo, I want to be the same age I was when Fat Joe's first album came out." And they're like,
"Straight up, like, are you dumb? You clearly have never been to the Bronx."
You think I don't wake up in the morning like, "Damn, I wish I could throw on some 38 size jeans, huh, nigga?" You think I don't miss my Gap fucking bamboo belt that was all stretched out?
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Let the shit hang mad long in the front for no reason.
Super long. Super long. Got to get a new belt. But I'm like, nah. You think I don't miss my Saucony's? You think I don't hate? You don't think I don't miss hating on niggas from Harlem wearing derbies? Because I don't know how to pull that shit off?
Yeah, nah. Nobody could pull that
think,
off. Shout out to
Harlem.
You think
I don't miss? You think I don't miss? Me and Mero miss when it was like, yo, you going out? Here's some Hush Puppies.
Word.
Like, yo.
Yo, Hush Puppies or Clarks be either or. Let's go. Wallabies or Hush Puppies.
Hush Puppies would hold you down for court dates, weddings, regular dates, summer jam.
Summer jam? Yo, come on. There's always been like a weird ass shoe. Like yo, the Diesel shoe. Shout out to the Diesel shoe. Had a great run in the early aughts.
Thank you for bringing that up. Thank you for bringing that up. I'm taking over the case. I represent Bronx Defenders. The Diesel shoe has been slandered and maligned on the timeline. And people were like, oh, that's nasty work. The Diesel shoe held us down.
For real?
The Diesel shoe held us down. When those bouncers was like, no sneakers, the Diesel shoe was all we had.
Yeah, facts. Talk about it. Yo, same way you got to put respect on Sarah J's name, you got to put respect on the Diesel Shoe's name because they put in that work. You know what I'm saying? They
absolutely.
Held us down for like 10 summers. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Stop playing.
Absolutely. Only 10 summers coming from the Bronx. But absolutely. That Diesel sneakers was like chitlins and other food that they made on plantations. Like you had to make something with the scraps. That's you what we mean? Had to do.
We okay? had to struggle, B. You don't know about that.
You don't know about when it got a little fancy, we had to go put a little Burberry on the side for a pregnancy?
You know what I'm saying? Come on. Motherfuckers talk about, yo, we wasn't doing that. We was wearing Maury's. Shut up. You wasn't wearing Maury's.
No.
Liar.
We was ugly. We was wearing terrible outfits. We had belts where the buckle had a LCD display.
Yes.
You remember that?
Yes.
And we
yes.
was in the club killing it. Killing it.
Yo, stop it. Yo, the nameplates came back, the digital nameplates. Like, yo, bro, come on. Had right above your dick looking like a bodega. You know what I'm saying? Right. Like hot sandwiches, cigarette soda.
Open 24 hours. Okay.
Hot salami.
Hey, right. Take a ticket. It's down below. But yeah, you know, you gotta live with the change in New York. I went for a walk from my house to Bloomingdale's last weekend. And New York is very different in Manhattan. There's some patches now you wouldn't even believe are sketch. Like, you'd be on, like, Madison and 70th, and, like, they just straight up selling Gucci bags. And the guy, I'm like, yo, the cops around? The guy's like, I don't care.
I don't give a fuck.
That's on them if they come around. I'm like, oh, okay. Shit different now. And, then, like, there's, like, heroin heads everywhere shooting up. But then it's just, like, they not really bothering you. They just doing their shit. Like, why are you coming in their area?
Who
cares? They found a cool area to shoot up at. So,
yeah, dog.
I guess.
You know how hard it is to find a chill spot? It's like smoking. It's like your drug of choice. You got to find a chill spot to post up. You know the vibes. We was all there. We was all teenagers. Could have smoked in the crib. You know what I mean? You got to find a spot to get right.
You could get right in more places than you can smoke. Because smoke emulates. It's like no one ever turns the corner and is like,
I smell dog food.
Who got the spike?
Like, no, I smell that cookie not. Dough, B. What's going on?
Yo, time you off, bro.
Yeah! Goddamn!
Because people was like, heroin use is getting out of control in New York. Do you remember that comic there was in the 80s that they did? It was about...
The guy with the hat?
Julio and Rita, and it was like about two dope fiends, and it was telling them how to clean their needles, and they used to have to put them on the subway and shit. And it was talking about if you had needles and you were sharing them, to take a little bleach and put it in there and water and then squirt it through.
It squirted
like,
out.
Yeah. And then like it was a whole saga, and like one of them got pregnant, one of them died or got AIDS. It was like, it was a whole thing, but there was no internet. So the only way to see it was when you rode on the train, and that was like,
yo, oh my god, yo, those train ads that had like parts.
Yeah, I mean that they had a captive audience. They were like, yo like,
so like, yo, I wonder what's gonna happen. Going? Next?
You gotta take the train. Wasn't no Ubers in 1980? You wasn't taking an Uber to a Curtis Blow concert, like yo.
Not at all. Curtis Blow was taking the train to the Curtis Blow concert.
Shit.
Yo, these are the cogs. Yeah, man. New York, well, you know what? I'm not going to... Shout out to... shout out to Foot Action and Fort Amore. They still got our sign up. You know what I mean? Like, we out here shining.
Oh, I saw that. I saw that. Shout out to everyone that copped the... still copying the ice cream, still copying the boot, the book. You know what I'm saying? Out here on different levels of shit.
You know what I'm saying? Paperback soon come, baby.
The more you buy... the less we gotta be in the streets robbing people. Because not necessarily because we gotta rob people, but you know, just some niggas gonna test you when your gun goes warm. So
yeah, yeah.
Every now and then you just gotta let niggas know. You know,
that's it.
If you fuck with big and heavy, you know,
we get up in your ass like a wedgie. You know what I'm saying?
But damn, what was it?
They got machetes for sale at Lowe's. Mad cheap. I didn't even realize.
There you go.
That. You know what I'm saying? Got 10 in the crib right now.
The shout out to DJ Khaled.
Another one.
Who dropped a new album and had Nas and Jay-Z on it.
Yes. Talking about crypto. Nas is over here talking about Coinbase.
Yes.
He got paid for Coinbase.
Everybody got excited. It was like, oh my God, Jay-Z and Nas on the same track. Except every time Jay-Z and Nas are on the same track, that shit is mid. That shit is mid. I'm being honest. I am being honest. All their stuff is just like,
Oh, brother, this guy stinks.
I think they get too excited at the fact that they're both on a track together.
Yeah.
And so their lyrics are just like, instead of trying to impress us, they're trying to impress each other. And we're like, this shit is whack.
Yeah.
Your man Nas talking about fucking cryptocurrency. Jay-Z talking about intermittent fasting. Get these.
My hair's free.
Come on, bro. Come on, bro. Come on, bro.
Yo, I think it's like what they say about boxers ducking their prime competition in their prime and then fighting them later on when they're washed up. It's like, dog, like we wanted this in like 1999. You know what I'm saying?
But if you think about it, like Black Republicans, success, all that, like none of them, you're thinking like a Jay-Z and Nas song, that shit should take you to like the fucking heavens. That should be the most lyrical, most flow, like,
you know what I'm saying?
Like, give us
a masterpiece.
Like, give us an easy, all they gotta do, give us like New York State of Mind Part 4.
Yes.
With Jay-Z and Nas.
That's it. Original beat.
Two rival drug dealers, same beat, and they're viewing each other over a courtyard and how they,
yep.
Like, give us easy shit like that. Nah.
Yeah.
They gonna talk about, yo, I just made Gerber for the twins. And like, no.
No, no, dog.
No.
I just used my NutriBullet to grind up some tomatoes and some watermelons and some flaxseed for my child. No.
Six Ethernet for Blue Ivy's remote learning. That's another way I'm money earning. You're like,
God. No. Guy, cut it out. No. That shit only
times down
that
about 20%. You're like, no,
that's
I don't want to hear about regular shit, Jay.
Yo,
talk about shit I can't do.
Yo, I checked the iPad. I got parental controls, right? Like, no, dog.
Thought about buying Dogecoin. Beyonce said, chill. That's the other B. You're like,
What? Like, okay, all right.
Right.
Damn,
yeah.
Dog. This doesn't slap out the car. Like,
well, who's playing? And then you gotta, and then, like, shout out to everyone on Twitter because y'all some goddamn liars. All of y'all.
You know, you're just a jerk. I mean, you're really just stupid. I mean, it's not even clever or funny or anything. It's just dumb.
Everybody was like, this album's so good. This album is summer vibes. That album was trash. DJ Khaled reuses samples that we're already familiar with, and he uses them in like a watered down way, so it doesn't even make any sense. And then people was just like, yo, remember when Wild Thoughts with Rihanna? Like, that shit ruled the summer. No, we were all disappointed by that song. That song was mad weak. Remember her little reference about like the 68 Jets or something?
Yo, that song made me so mad because everybody, it was like Z100 shit. You feel me? Like, it was not, it didn't bang like that. It didn't bang like that.
It
did not at all.
Like,
I was like, nah. Every time I heard that shit, it used to make me mad.
It is.
They play that shit in the mall.
It's like, recipes. It's like respect to Views is the anniversary of that. I think it's either the 5 or 6 year anniversary. Now that. Listen, that changed lives. That had people out here using the fucking filter with either the flowers or the dog face.
Yeah. Singing along.
Listen. Like 6 or 7 songs back to back to back. It wasn't even mad.
You feel me? There's children named Aubrey now because of that song.
Drake had you and your boys standing on a couch saying, key chain go jang-a-lang.
You're
fine with it. You're
feeling it. You're feeling it.
All right.
I try.
Good times. Oh, listen, people, you had a summer to get busy. There's no reason why someone shouldn't drop like the wild summer banger this year.
Because
people are hot and horny in the streets. They want something.
What are you doing?
Come on, give them something. You gotta give
somebody's
something.
Out here. Like, come on. So, like, yo, there's so many megastars out there. Like, y'all got to come up with something. Like, y'all had all COVID pandemic to think of shit for when we come out in June. Like, drop some heat, B. Like, damn. Come with another more life. You know what I'm saying? Another views. Feel me?
Yeah.
Something full of bangers. You know what I mean? But niggas out here just releasing mid into the public, like spores. Not really feeling it.
They need to make like a vaccination song where like you hold up your card, like, yo, who got vaccinated in February? Who got vaccinated in March? Some
shit like Fat Man Scoop. You got a motherfucker. You got a
Moderna. Oh,
Johnson. Be cool. If you got Johnson, be quiet.
Like, oh, I got a government recall. You're like, face drop. That was another thing. People were saying that song never banged in the club. It's true.
Stop lying.
Nah, it did. It was okay, like people saying, you know, people saying it doesn't still bang in the club, which is true.
No. That's true.
Now you hear it.
At its peak, that was like, and it was all sequencing. It was all about the DJ. The DJ, The DJ throws that shit on 11:30, maybe it's not banging. The DJ throws that shit on at 1:45 a.m.
Yeah.
Everybody going up. And yo, people forgot. You got $20 bill, put your hands up. And niggas put their hands up on crazy. Like, I'm just like, okay, I'm gonna rob you. Single ladies.
People forget about the Faith video and like all that shit.
Yeah.
Like niggas don't know. Come on, son.
Yo, I was standing in line to buy the first Xbox ever behind Fat Man Scoop, and I told him, I was like, yo, I appreciate you, what you do for the culture. And he was like, who the fuck are you?
Damn.
I was like, yeah, I'm just a guy. I enjoy you. You're a DJ.
Damn.
Shout out to you and the Aviators. That's the DJ break joint. If you have a DJ, you know that's like the I gotta go to the bathroom joint. Because that shit is like 12 and a half minutes long.
There you go. Shout out to the AVA on the vinyl. Uh-huh. But if you're really trying to go to the bathroom, you gotta switch to house techno music and switch it over to one of them 8-minute or 12-minute
extended mega mixes
with just drums beating up for like 12 minutes. You're just like, oh. Because you know you be in the bathroom. First of all, you got to get to the bathroom. There's a line at the bathroom. You got to be like, yo, I'm the DJ. There's going to be like one drunk person trying to fight you. Some nigga's going to try to give you a request.
Yep.
Now niggas watch you pee. And if you're trying to do a bump, you can't do it because they're watching you, you know. So you got to get right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yo, then you got to share and shit. Like, nah, we ain't trying to do that. I'm the DJ.
Bro, I'm the DJ. I'm not sharing. Fuck you.
I got to be up till 4 a.m. Not you. You're going to pass out in the booth.
I do whatever I want, bro. Like, fuck that. You kind of, listen, you came to hear me, bro. Like, don't fucking talk that. Who the fuck are you? Like,
who the fuck is you?
I'm the fucking DJ. And then, like, you're fighting, but then you can't, like, really you can't really fight because you're the DJ. You got to get back to the DJ booth, but you forget about that at the time because now you're all coked up. You're just like, fucking bro, you want this, you want these problems.
Oh shit, goddamn. Yo, oh my god, yo, we're here and we're chilling. I'm not gonna hold you, bro. I'm looking at those fours, I believe, right above the Sakais, and I'm wondering what they are because they are Michigan.
The what?
Colors. The yellow and the navy?
Yeah, this is the Michigan fours. Not Michigan. They're just some Detroit fours or some shit like that. I don't remember. I don't give a shit about sneakers anymore. Done with these shits. My whole new shit now is I am trying to sell a Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies to rob niggas. The thing is, when you sell people cryptocurrency, they can't help but to post it online, and that's where you get the real money on. Okay? When they're like, yo, I got this much money, and you just show up like, oh, okay. Guess what, diamond hands? Not so much.
Yeah, give me that.
All right.
Some dude was just like, yo, I'll give you a half of an Ethereum for an original painting. And I was just like, I don't even know what that means, dog. Like, now, what is
the thing about Ethereum is not even, apparently I bought Ethereum a long time ago and I've just been sitting on it. And unlike Bitcoin, you can't just sit on Ethereum. You need to do something with it. And if you live in New York State, you can't do it because New York State signed some weird legislation where there's a lot of cryptocurrency you can't buy because you live in New York State. You can't buy Dogecoin. You can't buy a lot of stuff. You have to use like a VPN. And it's not worth it because if you cash out, the IRS is going to be on your ass because they don't play with that shit. But the thing with Ethereum, you're supposed to like basically rent it to other people and then run like a little computer in your house and you make money off of that. But like that's a different level than Bitcoin.
Yikes.
And all the different coins, they have different rules and stuff. You know what I'm saying? And we could get in.
The market's getting flooded, also, bro.
Yeah, but the thing is, like,
people don't know how to play it because there's people who are just like, yo, okay, I read about this I read about this cryptocurrency on Monday. Let me invest on Thursday. You got people who were there from the minute it got launched and they fully invested and they already they're already cashing out because they're got in for so cheap and now they're tweeting about it to make other people buy it, which is like kind of a pump and dump, a little pyramid scheme-ish. But I mean, listen, a pyramid scheme only is problematic if you get in late. And so that tell your auntie and your uncle, okay?
You know what I'm saying?
All right? They don't want 64 bottles of Noni use? Sorry. That's on them. All right? Will you want me to drop this fucking parcel of Mary Kay products off at?
Yo, I'm going to keep it funky. Bernie Madoff had a run, B. Like, I wouldn't even be mad if I had Bernie Madoff's run. That nigga went to jail. He was like 70. Like, what else you got left? Were you 70? What the fuck you doing? Your dick don't even work no more? The fuck you? No, like, how you jumping?
Nah, he had pills for his dick and shit. Like, he was doing
he
it.
Had
like,
pills for his dick and shit. I love it. I mean, I love this podcast.
I mean, if he really wanted, I think the thing is, like, he was cashing out for so long, and if he getting turned in by niggas, that's what made it tight. Because he's like, oh, shit, niggas, damn, niggas going to, that's
they,
how it is.
Oh, they
niggas
flipped on me? In, damn.
Niggas flip on you. See?
It's like when Slim shot Bodie, bro. It's just like out of nowhere. Pow, hold that.
See? Like Street Smarts and FT said, don't trust anyone. Watch out for that. That's real hip hop. Y'all don't know about that. That's not on Spotify. You gotta get the actual vinyl for that. So
God damn. That's just a white label, dog.
Okay.
You gotta reopen Fat Beats and go get it.
I'm reopening Fat Beats, but it's gonna be called Fat PHAT Beats. And people are just like, oh, all the chicks that don't work there be thick. And I'm like, no, that's body shaming. Instead, that's what we're going to do, we're going to sell a lot of fatty foods and stuff, like a double bacon cheeseburger called the Hun, and like a deep fried donut called the Big L. We'll do that.
A deep fried blend called the Big L.
There you go. We're going to take sushi, coat it in sugar, and just like fry the fuck out of it and call it the Heavy D. I don't know.
Yeah.
That's how restaurants work in the Bronx now. You could just put any whack shit on the menu and just name it after hip hop niggas, and people be like, "Oh shit, I feel bad. Like I don't know who this is." Because I wouldn't be like Biggie, Tupac. I'd be like, "Yo, excuse me, you want this Resurrecta hamburger?" They're like, "What?" Mm-hmm. I'm like, "What?" I'm like, "Yo,
you want the Lord Finesse Filet?"
They're like,
"You know what I'm saying?"
I'm like, "What is yo, this? She wants the Lord Tariq pulled pork burger." They're like. Oh.
Pulled pork burger. Yo, I like how they just throw like one ethnic thing in like the mishmash of like Yakubian foolery. Like, yo, we got pine nuts and flax and a slice of plantain for that Caribbean flavor. I'm like, nah, dog.
Plantain. You gotta have the plantain. That's my new thing. The same way on the Lower East Side back in like the early 2000s, they used to have the frites place. I'm gonna have the plantain place. Ooh. And you just get three plantains for like $9. three greasy pieces of plantain. I'll be like, what sauce you want? Next. And listen, I'm going to get written up in New York Times, Grub Street, The Cut. Listen. There's going to be a line down the block. People will be like, oh my God, have you ever had this? This is amazing thing ever. Like, listen. That's it.
Yo, imagine motherfuckers become millionaires off tostones. Yo, my mom would whoop my ass. She'd be like, yo, I made these shits for years. Nigga, you didn't pay me shit. Now you a millionaire off fucking fried platanos? Eat a dick.
I'm about to open a beef patty place, but the beef patties are about to be $18 each. You know, cash niggas when they drunk. All right? You know, we've all been there. We've all been on the Lower East Side. Yeah. We passed by a taco stand. And, like, you don't even care about the price. You just like, yo, let me get this, this, and this. And you just hold on. And you waiting for them to call your number. You like, 26, yeah, that's me. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Then you just eating it, it's burning the top of your mouth. You're like, yeah.
I don't care. Give me that. Yo, let me get the chicken or rice, extra spicy, yo.
You might be so drunk, you take your phone out and take a picture for Instagram, like, yo, I fuck with this cart. And there's no distinguishing information about the cart, so niggas in the comments like, yo, is that on 3rd Avenue? You're like, I don't even remember.
I don't remember, dog. I don't even remember posting this, to be honest.
Like, yo, Like, I'm very lactose intolerant. There's a lot of cheese on that taco. I don't know what this is going on.
There's three different types of cheese in this shit. Mm-hmm. Fucking motherfucker put some shit called queso fresco in my shit. God damn it.
I remember that song, Three Types of Cheese. That was a big hit. Remember our grandfather's R&B group, the Quaaludes?
Yeah.
Remember that? They had a, types. It was a three types of cheese on this pussy. And it was like,
wow.
He got in trouble because it was about like discharge.
Yeah,
because apparently
we got
like,
ricotta,
my grandfather monster. Got like a yeast infection on his lip. And so he was like, I remember the audio. He was like,
tired of these whores. They just come around with their cheesy clits.
And like that was like the original song.
Yeah.
And it was like, boop, 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 boop. I was like, oh, shit.
Yeah, it was fire. And it's ill how they pivoted to like, and then that's how cheese, a lot of motherfuckers don't know that's how cheeses got created. You know what I mean?
Because
they just took the CLI out. You know what I'm saying? They just took out the CL. It was like, oh, cheese clits? No, that won't sell. Cheez-Its. You know what I'm saying? They made vagina flavored crackers.
It's weird that we're good at a podcast and we didn't even realize like our grandfathers were like fucking 70s R&B legends and shit. Like,
that's wild. It's so wild. But you know what it is? You don't want to brag about shit like that. You want to stand on your own.
I'm like, just a serendipity, though. It's just like, you know, like we never... I never even knew. My mother was like, yo, I don't want to tell you this because, you know, this is some shit. I don't want this to drive you the wrong way, but you established now, so you don't have to worry. But, like, they got banned from Ruby Tuesdays?
Yeah, dog.
Yeah.
Banned. They got the pictures to this day. That's like one of their things. Man. Like, they have them every Ruby Tuesday. It's like, yo, these niggas is banned for life. Get them out of here.
That's why. And I was like, studying the shit, I was like, all right, how bad could they song be? They had that song called Touch Me, and it was just like, I was like,
okay. I mean, it sounds pretty chill. It's not bad. Yeah. Okay, a little funky. Okay.
I got coke on my dick. I hope it doesn't make me sick.
Ow.
Open that clit. Get show me a trick. Hey, we're gonna run the train.
And
I can't explain.
Oh, yeah.
Mero shooting heroin in his vein. Give him brain. We are just some nasty niggas from the Bronx.
Yeah.
Hopefully, our kids get something with Square Cash. And then they don't have to work a lot.
Yeah.
And then, like, Victor will help them secure some deal for another season of premium cable. And I don't know what I'm talking about. Let's go out.
Yeah. I was like, crack cocaine. What?
I was like, what? That? I was like, that? I was like,
what the fuck was that? Yeah.
That sounded like.
They were just like,
specific.
Everybody was singing in the chat? Yeah, what the fuck was
but
that?
But I look back, like, everyone was just wild coked out. So.
It made perfect sense. It made perfect sense. That's why the ad lib, that crack cocaine ad lib at the end was just like, I was just like, this was like a wild non sequitur, but it made perfect sense. It fit in.
I'm reading. I'm looking through my uncle's receipts. He spent almost $40,000 on reconstructive foreskin surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Like he would rip it off after every performance.
Yep. That 80s year was real, bro. 80s year was real. Like that shit was not stepped on, bro. That shit was puree. Like you rub that shit between your fingers, bro. That shit disappeared.
The shit your uncle used to do with the plantain and like chick women's butts. I mean,
yeah, that was wild.
That
was wild
nowadays.
I seen a VHS tape, bro, and I put it in, and I was just like, it looked like the tub girl. I was just like, oh, this is out of control.
The wildest part is how Shorty actually gave birth to a plantain, like 6 months later.
Facts. Wild.
And then, absolute like, banana. But he had to come on tour with them, which was weird. It was like, plantain group?
Yeah. But you know what it was? Everybody thought it was like, yo, he's a mascot. He's a mascot. Yo, he's a mascot. Nah, it was a child, bro.
Damn.
You were hiding a child.
And then niggas ate him. That shit was like crackers.
That was, that was super extra. They didn't need to do all that.
Anyway, this is the part of the podcast where we implore you to check on your daughters and make sure they still have their hymen. As we were talking to T.I.
No! Yo!
That's right. This podcast is paid for by Big Hymen. All right?
Yo, Big Hymen!
It's the Hymen Fisherman. Like, they're like, no relation to Gordon.
Yo, fam, can somebody explain to me what the fuck is going on with the Chelsea Boot guy and Umar? Like, what is going on?
I got.
Can you explain it to me?
That's not even my part of Twitter. Apparently, the Chelsea Boot guy be commenting on women looks and shit, but like, I don't know if he really be fucking with women. Now he's going back and forth with Umar, but I don't really, I got all that shit blocked because I'm trying to get money. So yeah. I don't really know what's going on.
Same.
So
that's what I'm saying. I'm like getting like mad. You know when you, when motherfuckers is blocked or muted and you don't see this shit, but you see like 10% of a conversation, you're like, what the fuck is this? It's just like a random tweet. Like, I'm like, what is this? I don't want to dig deeper into this.
No.
No. It's, I don't want to go there.
It's like, if it comes in front of you, pause. No, no pause. If it comes in front of you, you stand in your masculinity, you say, good job, Captain. But yeah, it's one of those things where if it's like pops up in front, I'm just like, no, I don't know these backstories. I don't know these characters. I don't know this stuff.
No.
That's it.
This is,
we're at the
boring point
now. Our Twitter is just to do inspirational tweets that do not apply to life and make you feel bad for not being rich. For example, shout out to James Harden. Big that man up.
Shout out to James Harden. Out here.
He tweeted, we all have the same 24 hours. What are you going to do with it? Listen.
Wow.
Listen.
Wow.
Think about how bad that makes you feel. Because now, like, if you're not popping, you're like, damn, I'm not working hard enough. I could do more. I sleep too much. I could get another job.
I could be James Harden.
James Harden, I could do better. James Harden, I could do better. No, nigga, no.
James Harden got
assistants. James Harden got fucking niggas making meals for him. Niggas giving him fucking steroids and shit. You know.
Yo, dog. It's, you know what the wild shit is? Yo, and this is going to sound wild.
Allegedly.
When you get to, like, you know, TV, Hollywood, whatever the fuck, like, you actually need these motherfuckers, B. Like, there's so much shit going on. Like, your average human being cannot keep track of this shit, bro. Like, unless you're very, very organized.
I thought about that the other day, and I was like, nah, it's a crock of shit. Because if you had a regular job, you'd make this happen. Like, without the assistant and all that shit. Like, without someone to take... If you don't have someone to do this, you would physically have to write this stuff down. That's what's so funny to me. I'm just like, yo... We physically have another person to, like, book when we got to do a Zoom, da da. At one point in our life, we would have been the person doing all this, and we probably would have done a more efficient job because it would have just been us, and we're not paying someone. Like,
I mean,
or maybe I'm just talking for myself, but...
Yeah, you definitely are, because I'm like, yo, fam, my entire life is a fucking... What is that? Nah, it's not Red Panda that does it. The niggas that spin the plates on the sticks... Like, my entire life is 28 plates spinning on a stick. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I got this over here, I got this over here, I got this over here, I got this over here. It's a lot. And I think, I'm pretty sure I have undiagnosed ADHD. Like, I'm very, you know what I'm saying?
Listen,
so.
even when I was moving out white like the Metro North, I sure was an organized motherfucker. I was the only person that had post-it notes.
That's the only thing I could organize in.
I was like, yo, re-up at 2. All right, see Pat or whatever, da-da-da-da-da, allegedly.
Yeah, you know. Allegedly, yeah, my guys, you know, allegedly, I was about to say, like, family members' name. No, we're not doing that. Allegedly, that's the only thing I keep track of. I'm like, yo, every Friday, I get my check, boom, I'm coming in here, I'm reading up, bing, bang, bing, I'm getting cleaned out by Sunday night, Monday, go back to work, Friday, wash, rinse, repeat, you know what I'm saying? Like, over and over and over and over again. And I was just like, yo, that's literally the only thing that I'm like, yo, you have to do this thing. You know what I'm saying? It's just wild, B.
Right.
You know, skill sets, man.
You got to use what you got.
You know what I'm saying?
To the top. Because if not, you don't make it, bro.
You're going to try. Inspirational tweet.
Also, shout out to Melinda Gates. She's out here. You know what I'm saying?
Hot girl
she
summer.
Out here. She's out here. She got the wild, weak boyfriend that you know you could beat up. Listen,
yo, fam,
Melinda.
Listen, you got to bag, yo. Listen, I'm telling you, I'm here to tell you right now, you got to bag Melinda Gates at the next Pizza Zoo, bro. You got to do it.
I'm good. Hopefully, somebody else, go play with that. I am good. But I mean, shout out to Melinda Gates. Shout out to everyone that's like, oh my God, she's gonna do great things now that she's not with Bill Gates. She's gonna vaccinize Africa. And I was like, no, she was bad already. Like, it wasn't Bill Gates making her be bad, nigga. Like, she likes being rich. She don't give a fuck about poor people. Like,
I start tweaking when people say shit like that. Like, yo, they're gonna, like, no, fam. Nobody except that the dude with the long hair that was just like, I'm cutting my salary to pay everybody in my company $70,000 a year. Like, I feel like that's the only dude I've ever seen in life be like, yo, I want y'all to be prosperous. Like, no, rich niggas want to stay rich.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And keep y'all motherfuckers broke.
Yeah, on Twitter, people are always just like, oh, if I had this much money, I would do this. I was like, no, you wouldn't.
No, you wouldn't.
Because once you have it, and you'd be like, yo, okay, how do I keep this?
Yeah.
Because, like, and I think that was the fucked up. Who's the quote? And it was just like, yo, I can't help poor people by being poor. Which sounds like the wild fucked up thing to say, but it's true.
Because you know?
If you give all your money away, what happens?
That's when
you got bills? You know what I'm saying? You got to listen. Listen, you got to keep it in the family and generate more. And the problem is you generate more and you're like, oh, I'm going to do this to this food kitchen. But, wow, that new Ferrari looks all right.
Yo. Also, I mean, like, this whole system is set up so that if you do G off and, like, do some shit like that, like, it's like, yo, you hit your accountant and they're like, yo, this shit is a tax write-off, right? I can write this shit off, right?
Well, I mean, the whole thing is, like, I think if you're black or brown, because, like, nobody's like, yo, we got to eat all the billionaires. And people's like, yeah, let's eat Jay-Z and Beyonce. And everyone's like, whoa, 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 whoa. They just got it. Let them enjoy it for a little while.
Let them enjoy it for a little bit.
You know what I'm saying? Like, there's no guillotines in front of Beyonce and Jay-Z's houses. There's billionaires you fuck with and there's billionaires you don't fuck with. All right, let's keep it funky.
Yeah.
All right.
And to be real, if there is a grain of truth in it. Like, yo, Jay's a billionaire, no doubt. All right, whatever. But he's not the fucking Renard Arnault or whatever the fuck. That's like old money. You feel me? Like, you were born a billionaire, dog. You feel me? Like, you didn't make that. You didn't make that happen. Like, I just sat and the money just popped off.
I want to apologize for my earlier statements. There was someone with a guillotine in front of Beyonce and Jay-Z's house. It was me for that trash-ass verse. Jay, I don't like that shit, bro.
I feel like
this nigga talk about fucking drugs. This nigga talking about ducking for paparazzi. This nigga talking about intermittent fasting. This nigga about to talk about fucking compression socks. Talking about, yo, my level was high. Bay use Alestra. I'm like, nah. I don't like that. Yo,
that's adult contemporary rap. Oh,
yo, stressful day. I had a salt lamp to calm me down. I'm like,
oh god. I took a bath with some Epsom salts from Himalaya. Like,
I got a hydro machine, but it doesn't have water in it. Shout to Victor. I'm like, Victor, can I talk to you? You give a whole rowing machine recommendations, my nigga? Wow. So you met Jay-Z. And the first thing out your mouth was, yo, how can my guys get to the Rock Nation brunch? You was like, yo, my nigga, you look like you skip arm day. How can I help you? I got a rowing machine for you. Wow. I knew it. Because that's how Jay-Z be telling on himself. Because he can't just say something. He always got a whisper afterwards with an ad-lib. And I think that's how he got caught cheating by Beyonce. Because he probably was like, yo, I was just out in the streets. He was like, I was fucking with Becky. Like, yo, what'd you say?
Like, yo, wait, sir.
Yo, Beyonce, I love you. I'd never cheat on you. Yo, that's crazy. She doesn't even know I had my finger in another woman's pussy.
You're like, oh, wow. Oh, wow. Call me finger bang man. Damn. The goddamn hoe back at it again.
Also, completely unrelated, shout out to Square Cash for buying Tidal. Hey!
Goddamn, man. Your man Jack back at it again.
Which means we don't even have to worry about the Rock Nation brunch. We might be inviting Jay-Z to the Square Cash brunch.
Ooh!
Relax. Okay, all right. I'm wild.
Pump your brakes, my G. Pump your brakes.
Jay-Z gonna get there. He gonna be like, oh, where's the food? I'm like, nah, I mean, like, I got the Foreman grill right there. I got some expectations. It's the eggs that are inside the carton. So what would you like, Big Chief? Like,
nah. You know what I want? I'm going to buy you two niggas. Yeah, my two NFTs. Just stand there.
Nah. Like, Hov, I got to do this omelet brunch. Like, I got fucking Casanova on the Zoom from jail. He runs some Swiss and this shit. Listen, baby.
You non-fungible from now on. It's the Rock.
I feel like that's a slur. I don't know what that means. I don't feel comfortable with you using that. But,
listen, my hair's free. I'm carefree. You are a token. I'm a billionaire. What you gonna do?
Wow. While you talking real spicy for someone who's not gonna you talking real spicy for someone who's not gonna have food for another 8 hours. That's right. I know when your intermittent fasting starts, nigga. You hungry?
Oh shit.
You hungry?
Oh damn.
All right.
Oh, you cool?
You want some of this baklava? You can't have it.
Damn.
You can't have it. You about to pass out, nigga.
Let me just smell it. Let me just smell it.
All right.
Come on. Can you put your finger in it? Let me just smell it one time, please.
This nigga intermittent fasting. Wow. Wow.
Yeah.
Imagine you just mind your business. It's like some school kids get on a train, like, this nigga intermittent fasting. Like, you just grab your shit and run off the train. Like, oh shit.
Bro. Yo, motherfuckers are making fun of Kyrie, but Kyrie's like actually like observing religious shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But like, dog, damn, fam, like that's got to be tough, dog. Like to fast and like have water and then go play dream, NBA bro. Basketball.
No, the dream is Jay-Z. How he's just doing like he's rich. When you rich, you just do bullshit like that. Like you get to the point that like, I zoom in with you and I'm like, what you doing? You're like,
just I'm cupping.
Practicing. I'm just practicing tantric sex. I've been on pause for 5 hours. The energy's just cruising through me. I'm like, all right, don't turn your camera on, nigga.
All right, please, please, keep that shit off. Keep that shit off. I practice tantric masturbation.
Nigga got the wild statue of the Jeffrey Toobin behind him. Like, wom, wom, wom. The tube god.
She's just emanating horny.
Baby, let's tube. Ooh-wee. Jeffrey, yeah. My hands are full. If only there's something you had that could get that door open. He's like, I got you. Disney's like, no, we are not making. They're like, all right, we did WandaVision and we did Captain of We are not doing Captain Tubing. I was like, what's wrong? Bro, come on,
well,
bro.
Why not? It makes perfect sense,
bro.
Dog.
Like, bro. Like,
hello?
How else gonna beat Thanos? You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's you gotta hit with the Cam Newton.
That's a tagline. Like, turn your cameras on. Like, come on. Like, come on. Tubin, get more foreskin over there. You're like, oh, wow, what's going on?
Oh, wow. Okay.
You're like, oh, this ain't for the kids. Oh, shit.
They got a best boy grip, got a whole different meaning.
You don't want to see when they wrap Thanos in foreskin and they almost get the glove off because Thanos is like, yo, this shit is, yo, y'all wildin'.
Yo, I thought this was calamari. Y'all are going too hard.
I taste marinara. It's like, no. He didn't wash his deck.
Wow.
They had a thread on Twitter about women. They were complaining about guys having dirty dicks. And then halfway through, people was just like, but you let him beat. So.
Yeah, like, I feel like you could tell if somebody got a dirty dick just by, like, looking at him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Observing.
But what if it's the case if you're just like, what's that smell? Is that me or her?
Oh, true.
Not a problem I've had in the 2000s. Maybe a problem back in high school and junior high. But, you know, sometimes you got to ask questions.
You feel me? That's why I was just like, yo, fam, like, the way I take, like, you got to thoroughly shower your joint. And Eater Gang, you got to thoroughly shower, dog. Like, you know what I'm saying? Don't play. Drop the top and scrub a dub. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, like, but I mean, that's for you. But I mean, some of us like a light vinaigrette on our meat. So, I mean, just, you know, it's just like, whatever.
Yo, I did the. Yo, fam, you know when you like, you in a situation and you know that the situation is going to end in, you know, coitus. You know what I'm saying? You might be getting a little toppy. So I like to smell nice. You feel me? So I had the shea butter body scrub in the shower. You feel me? It's like got a little coconut.
This Bilal ass nigga. All right.
So
this flow tree ass say yes ass nigga. Wow. This Jill Scott, let's go for a long walk and eat grits ass
right.
Nigga. Wow.
That's right.
Got the sandalwood
on deck.
Burn this Raphael Sadiq. Oh, this Tony never rains in California.
That's
ass
right.
Nigga.
Come on. I'm listening to Urban Hang Suite while I take a shower. Wow. You know the fucking vibes.
Wow. This something ass nigga. Wow.
Yo, but fam, yo, the warning. Like, yo, fam, that shit is not made for the tip of your dick. Like, I'm here to tell you right now, that shit is not made to scrub your exposed, whatever the fuck this shit is called, the glands, shaft? No, it's not the shaft.
Listen,
the head?
If you're a real New Yorker, you've been washing your dick using Lifebuoy. All right, that got the sand in it.
Ah!
You got the extra grit in there, bro.
Boy.
Okay. Yo, women love the women love boy. The scab. Yeah, bro. Yo,
look at yo, that's the jelliest soap ever. Yo, fam, that's like a camera online. Yo, you doing life boy. You gonna be washing with life boy.
I mean, listen, it's real. It's real deal Holyfield. And now you hookers and hoes know how I feel. Come on.
That's right.
Fucking vibes.
Yo.
But yo.
I feel like we're past the are you still using boss soap though? Like, are you still fucking with like Irish Spring and shit like that? Cause I'm not. I mean, I was. I didn't even go hold you. I was.
I really don't feel comfortable being on a Zoom with four niggas talking about how I wash myself. I'm sorry.
Listen, yo, let's
talk
about
it. Like, I'm not rich like that. Like,
let's get into it. You know what I'm saying?
No, let's not. Like,
you go face down or you go feet up?
I have, you know, I use a very special, very expensive body oil that comes from Egypt, and it comes from the same place the MyPillow guy gets his cotton.
Oh, that Egyptian
it's
musk?
It's actually from the MyPillow guy. He said it's called boysenberry. It's supposed to be like the best oil to clean your body. He was very frantic when he was talking to me, and he thought Zoom meant running around very fast while he was on the payphone. So I don't know if like where my money went, but it's working a little something.
When he shows up to like your crib with four pots of sticky IHOP syrup, you're gonna know the vibes.
I'm like, yo, could you? He's like, I don't have time to say. You want these? You want these or not? You want these? I'll just stop right here. I just want these here.
Huh? You want to do it? You want to go? You want to go? Let's go.
He's like, you know what? I'm gonna take a quick nap. He just takes a 30-second nap and he jumps up like, best why I sleep in the whole wide world. My pillow's like, I gotta go.
Yeah.
He just like, bites off a hubcap with his teeth and runs away. He's just like, oh, right. All right, sir. You're doing what you want. You're doing what you want there, boy. You know what you want there, boy.
I'd be wondering if infomercial niggas is really that energetic in real life, or if that's just like, you know, I'm just trying to get this bag.
Because when we start,
the flex-seal dude be real hype about everything.
When we start doing shitty infomercials, you'll find out. I'll be like, wait a minute, you're not cooking your bacon one strip at a time, and the audience is like, what? I'm like, yeah, bro.
Why would we do that?
Look at this. You could save $70 a year on bacon. They're like, what?
Whoa.
Like, deep fry your bacon, bro.
Like, that doesn't make any sense. Don't worry. It's on sale. Two easy payments of $25.99.
How does your bacon stay fresh? They're like, wax. That's right. We're dipping the bacon in wax. It'll stay fresh for 4 months, bro. They're like,
this don't sound right.
This does not seem safe.
How do I get the wax off? Is it like a bottle of fucking...
put a little turpentine on there to keep the termites away. Like, okay, all right. Okay. That doesn't seem safe.
Why does it say store and garage?
Make sure it's ventilated. Oh.
Yo. Oh, God. Shout out to the Knicks. Doing well.
Yeah, I would say they're winning right now, but if I told you that they were winning, you'd be able to triangulate when we recorded this. Because clearly, they're not playing while you're listening. And that's a security flaw, and we can't have that. Not because it's dangerous for us, it's just we don't want our security to clap one of you Bodega Hive members. And by security,
right.
I mean my cousin Roscoe. Or just me. Listen to this, how far we've come. The Skittles and Wrigley Corporation is suing the popular brand Z Skittles for weed.
Really? Wow.
You know how them Z Skittles hit? They be hitting.
Yeah,
good.
Wow.
That
was like the first gas. I feel like when we arrived in Cali, we were like, "Yo, this is it."
So you know, we stand with Z Skittles. If you want to stand with Z Skittles, send me a Mero Bitcoin, and we will buy a legal defense for.
You feel me? Yo, you can cash app it to me.
For somebody, for anybody. For your mama too. Does your mama need Cash App? I don't know. If your mama needs Cash App, why are you listening to this? You should be out working.
You should be out here working, trying to get hustle, bro. Get your mom some bread.
Collect
what
some cans
you?
And shit. Your mom, you know, your mom's like, your mom.
Come on, B. She birthed you, B.
Also, reminder: you can buy Bitcoin on Cash App.
Yes.
But if you buy Bitcoin on Cash App, it belongs to the exchange. It does not belong to you. You must export it out of the exchange and put it into a personal wallet. Wallets can be digital, they could be physical, or they could be on paper. But remember, if you don't own your keys, you don't own your Bitcoin. That's,
can you print out like a receipt of your Bitcoin?
You do get that, and then there's like you can create a 15-word passphrase that if you memorize it, say you go to jail and you don't have a contact to a computer or whatever, as long as you remember that 15-word passphrase, you get all your Bitcoin back. Blow your
15 words.
So if you're going to jail, take all your money and put it in Bitcoin. Because you're going to jail anyway. Let it work. It's going to invest. When you get out, you're going to probably make more money than you did going in if you had put it inside a savings account.
Yeah.
And that is one to grow on. So
that's right. Put it in there. And remember the Bobby Shmurda's verse from Computers. That'll be your password. And you'll be good. You know what I'm saying? When you hit the bricks, you'll be good. You'll be living good. You know what I'm saying? Eating king crab legs and shit. You feel me? I don't know why that's like the epitome of luxury to me. I'm such a mentally broke motherfucker. I be getting king crab legs. I'm like, yo, I'm out here doing it. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, for the Bronx, City Island's right there. You know how we
do. Yeah. You know the vibes. You know.
And you know the fucking vibes. Episode 241 of the world's most 2 and 5 train Manhattan bound. You know.
You feel me?
2 train out in here. The building. You know, say shout out to the 2 and 5. The Red Line, the Red Birds, as they called it.
You feel me? West Farmsy Street, man, gang.
It's been your boy, Desus Nice, a.k.a. Young Chipotle, a.k.a. Pocket Stay Fat Like Tyrio, a.k.a. Pocket Stay Fat Like, here we go.
Hey.
And that fat means P-H-A-T. Some of them I know you, but Young Day Party, Young Hot Take, DJ Fuego, Mr. Nando's with a Rendo, Mio Novazeta, Noveta Equato, Mikhail going off the Juve boss, MC Luke P. Put up for 40 with who? Your goddamn shorty.
With your motherfucking shorty, dog.
Goddamn shorty.
Like, right.
I hope you realize what that means.
Uh-huh.
Like, your shorty's in here. So.
That's right. Might want to keep an eye.
Act accordingly. Act accordingly. I won't explain it again. Do I have to?
Nah. Don't do it to him. Don't give it to him. Don't give him that info.
Okay, don't talk to me in the Uber pool, which no longer exists because of COVID, but one day I'll be back.
Hey.
And still don't talk to me because I don't know you.
You don't know
the original I plus one got a plus one, so listen, boy, don't make a fuss, son.
Just relax,
just
bro.
Just be cool, man. Like
yeah, look at your
phone.
And shit.
I showed you your vaccination card. Like, why are you being weird? Why are you?
Yeah,
weird?
Dog.
Like,
we all got vax cards. Dog, what the
we
fuck,
all got vax
man?
Card, bro. Like, why are you being Please. Like that? These Rossi yeah, Jamaican Jew. Man. Okay. Jermaine Avocado Toast, Young Pop, the Ghost of Mufasa, Young Chakuni without the coonery, a.k.a. Chili Limon, left-handed reliever for the Yankees. Okay,
Hey, Poppy, I'm very nice.
You know the fucking vibes, bro. I'm just out here just trying to, you know, just be a person out here. And I can't because you know what else? I'm Tufung Jones. I'm DJ Machina. I'm Jay Chuckles. I'm Stanley Cups.
Talk to him.
The human doctor, Bonner's label, Dalu. Dionato the Trapio, Mr. 240, Pico Akepito Blurry, a.k.a. DJ Woolite, a.k.a. listening to Washed FM.
Yeah.
Today we got the Bronx Legends. You know who it is.
Oh, boy. Oh.
Sometimes I rhyme slow,
sometimes I rhyme quick. Oh.
Quick. Sometimes I rhyme slow, sometimes I rhyme quick. Quick.
Sometimes I rhyme slow, sometimes I rhyme quick.
I'm sweeter and thicker than a Chico stick. Here's an ice cream cone.
Oh. He went to Bay Plaza.
Bay Plaza to catch a flick.
You know what that is? You know what that is? That is nice and smooth. You know that? Oh, nice and smooth. It's funky. Oh, some hip hop junk. You know the fucking vibe.
Oh my God, beautiful song.
Pay respect.
You know what I mean?
Curry Goat, Deezus Spicer, Jamal Hashman, the Bronx, Celine Dion, Ray, and Nephew's Nephew, the Moreno, You Cannot Contain, the Human Memory, What to Jaw, Young Aaron, the Racist Provocateur, Henrik Budkost, Nelson Mandela, Sergio Can't See Me, Vladimir Buffin, the Human Word is Melting in Your Mouth, Mr. Bex on Deck and Tin, Ricky Tiki Squabby, Greg Popovich, Morrissey, Fish Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi, not Maccabee, but I got a cucumber, the juices are pressed, but your boy never is, I am the art, damn it, the Dundada Ganoush, No More Cup of Noodles, the Prince of Peckham, the Fashion Nova, Casanova, William A. Sen, 5 cent, 10 cent dollar, forget the small change, give me big money wine, the only actor must do is Dipset, Mr. Saga, catch me at square one, top left, because man's is Marv, Chew Risotto, Mr. So Paul, because all I do is count checks and jerk off, we got OJ, Purple Stuff Soda, and it's me, Sonny D. David Uriman, these expensive, these red bottoms, these bloody shoes. Smokeem, Noah, Andrew Kunanen, aka Junior, Energy God Junior, come sit down, Palm Beach Charger. Corby Pet Coca, actual bitch on freeze.
On
topic of gossip and sayasit. Shout out to the 11791, aka Grandpa Joe, because you see Charlie, you see me, don't touch that golden
ticket.
You
know what it is.
Your man, Dead Eye Desus, Morning Sheriff. Mr. Shopping at Street Easy, with a bad breezy, please believe me. The black Asiatic who crack your back like automatic crackmatic. Mr. La Marina, Mesh Marina, with fresh Mr. Marina, cold. The medium sheet mask killer, illa, illa. No one could be illa. The black Zach Moore, support Moore, young KBI. It's your personal Desus, a.k.a. the Pele of Peloton, JPI Quasa, Inspector Teradek, Nickel Bagstar Cozy, James Vaxton, and your problematic bae. It's not a secret family if you still haven't contacted them after a year. Hey.
Hey now. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the number one art form on the planet. And I am your boy, the Kid Mero, a.k.a. the Human Durag, a.k.a. Donovan McDab, a.k.a. Curve Gotti, a.k.a. Triz Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Yes, sir. A.k.a. Skirt loader, jump the curb, hit your fucking dog, and keep him moving. Ask me if I give a fuck. Your leash is longer than 6 feet. It's not, stupid. You know what I'm saying? Observe social distancing, please. I don't fucking baby, I fucking man. You know what I'm saying? No need to check the guesses because everything is fucking closed. You know what I'm saying? AKA CC Dabathia, AKA Tiger Back, what's smoke a 3 gram blunt to hit you with this 9 iron? Get into the shmoney and the smoke is your boy Goldman Schmack. AKA Mesh Montana. Hey, I went from Roach Motels to Koi Ponds. I think I did pretty well for myself. I got my kids out here in these streets. They are so drippy. Yo. Pyre Moss is making a whole kids line for my kids. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm popping like that. You know what I'm saying? Out here. Dad of the year shit. You know why? Because I'm the motherfucking dad of the year. You dig? A.K.A. Ben Smack Biombo. A.K.A. Diego Maradona. A.K.A. Dick in your Bay Motombo. A.K.A. Carlos. I'm sorry, my queen. I must request access to your lady cave. I apologize. The pussy does not belong to me. It belongs to you and you alone. Thank you. A.K.A. Bottles Antenna. So smooth, I fall asleep at the wheel and crash the zip car. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. The Dominican Dandada. A.K.A. I'm going to show you my card again. There's definitely money on it. Stop fucking trying to play me before I call your manager that DVRs the show and embarrass you, my nigga. Don't worry about how high I am. Just put the fucking snacks in the bag and let's go. I'm not trying to be outside. You feel me? I haven't washed this mask in 2 days. A.K.A. Romeo Santos, tu favorito mami, so zanny, let me black out. A.K.A. Latin El Dutchie.
Hello, is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes that you've been coronavirus. So why can't I swing this blunt to you?
You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Tom Brady got my balls deflated more than Bobby Crafts. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Feel the ass ice. I want to explore your my cosmos, my conceptually, of course. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Lil Snoozy for first nigga to tap on live. Been social distancing before that Rona. A.K.A. Finally, Messi MVP of Gelato. A.K.A. Zano Benefield. I gotta get some sticks. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Joe Hookah. I dare you.
To what?
To smoke with me.
Where at?
At Mama Sushi. You know what I'm saying? R.I.P. Black R.O.B. You know what I'm saying? Harlem's finest. You know what I'm saying? Rest please, Black Rob, a.k.a. I'll be in Medicine Cabinet. You know who the fuck it is. It's the Zen Man. It's got a bit of a weed up about a boat. A.k.a. Rico Sabroso. Baby, the post who 5 minutes got garbage down the way. A.k.a. Nino Brown. Shut the car down. For an hour, just for sanitizing purposes, we'll have them krills jumping in a minute. A.k.a. Professor Hornell West, you know what I'm saying? Professor of Horny Nigga Studies at the University of Horny. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. live harassing patrons inside and outside MSG because there's seating available. It's the E-Stream on Stevie B doing all his greatest hits like,
I wanna be the one your TV is fucking. Yeah, and don't take love. Don't let me leave.
You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. I'm at my friend's sister. I'm never going to fail. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Woo!
Every week, mate, you know what I'm saying? I have to implore and tell you that other rock stars are for Gacy. There's only two left, mate, of which I am one. And that's the Bodega Boys. And I am. The plantain sleeping over in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on tree mark. Shaming you for standing in line for brunch. You know what I'm saying?
We're not ready yet, bro. We're not ready to fully open up, dog. We need more vaxes, dog. You know what I'm saying? Stay safe, B.
A.k.a. back at it, blazing trails and blazing that runs pack. It's Marmelo's Anthony.
For three.
Bang. You know what I'm saying? He might take Bron out the playoffs. You never know what could happen in the NBA. Yo, listen, if you see me at Target, and I'm higher than a 7-foot Israeli basketball player's yarmulke, approach me like a motherfucker, Earth-sized mammal dog, because I might react radically, and you won't like that. You know what I'm saying? Just let me look at my snacks in peace. You know what I'm saying? AKA Tom Petty and the Ball Breakers, baby, because anytime I'm in the Zoom, baby, I'm free. Free bowling. Just letting hang. You know what I'm saying? AKA Soul Fake Lean to your favorite slime collar rapper. He is high off the garbage juice at the bottom of my garbage can. I just threw out the garbage, and every day I collect the juice at the bottom, and that's what your favorite rapper is drinking, y'all. Enjoy. AKA, hey kids, it's Benzo the Clown. Hire me for your kid's birthday party. We're safe again. We're all fully vaccinated, and Mr. Fun Fun has all his shots. Right, Mr. Fun Fun?
That's right. I have all my shots, kids. So, I mean, like, also, you guys want to do cryptocurrency? One of the phrases they use is called diamond hands. So, like, if any of you guys want something and you want me to, like, hold it for a while, I have diamond hands. Like, I'll hold something, like, something hold until it gets hard. Like, if that's what you guys want.
He's talking about a digital wallet, kids.
To the moon. Jumping on the moon.
Mr. Johnson. Get in the van. Let's go. Skirt.
And now, it's the time, papi, for if you have SAP, please turn it on right now.
Oye, coño, que lo que bobo, llegó el hijo Titi FIFA, coño, el malo que estuvo bajando con la papa prendida, no me de cotorra, coño, que el palo que tiene Tito te tumba el coco, mamá huevo, la para la grasa. Dime, coño, ¿qué es lo que tú, qué tú te buscaste? Si yo vi tu coro y toritos son guaremate, coño. Yo tengo más cadena, coño, que una fábrica de bicicleta, coño. La envidia no mata, pero mortifica, coño. You know what I'm saying? Shout out a la casa, Showtime. Shout out Cash Out. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Hasan y Sene, que pone la fucking nota. Shout out Desus, buena. La nota jamaquina. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Victor Marte, el papi de la lady, 24 quilates de sexy en esa melena. Wow, qué papi más duro. Shout out nena de la bodega, dai la más dura, la planta, la insuperable. Shout out mi presidente Pío. Secretario de Defensa, activo con el cañón. Avísame que lo suelto. Llegó mi manito friki, 12 años. Pues no se boca floja. Yo no hago coro con palomo ni chivateo. Que descanse para mi manito sexo y mi manito Chadwick y toda la gente que ha morido a las manos de una policía corrupta. Quédate en la casa, lávate los fucking manos, ponte tu mascarita y vacúnate, please. Y mi gente de Colombia, estamos activos, estamos el ojo, los ojos del mundo te están mirando, Colombia. Me quité, ya.
You know the vibes. Episode 241, another one. Bodega Boys in the building. Shout out to Cash App. You know the vibes. Another one for your ear holes. Enjoy it. Jeez. Be safe out there. Still pandemic, even if you're vaxxed up. Don't be one of those people that gets vaxxed up and still gets COVID, because we're going to roast you.
So, oh, we're going to fry you, bro.
And we out. Peace.